wanted to start this evening by saying one thing, that we need a revolution.
Yeah.
I want y'all to say it with me. We need a revolution. We need a revolution. It's been laid out pretty clearly from everything that you've just seen in front of you. But for me as well, this is deep. This is personal for me. And not just in my own life, but in the life of communities that I frequently go into. Maybe a year ago, I was going out canvassing, knocking doors, maybe not far from here in Baltimore City, knocking on doors, talking to people about the upcoming election. And I ran into a lady who, I believe she said she was about 75 years old. And she was taking care of her mother, who was 90 years old. Both of them sick. Both of them not really able to take care of themselves, but trying to take care of each other. And I did not see a social safety net for either of them. And believe me, they tried, and they talked to me, and I tried to connect them to the right people at the city council, the right people at the state delegation, but it was real suffering. And for me, it's deeply personal. Just before I came up on the stage this evening, got my fiance texting me about my father-in-law who's looking for work because he can't get a job because he has a felony. So this is deep. This is personal. We have people walking around here who can't find work, who are standing outside begging as we're driving into the city, who envision nothing for their futures. And these are the folks that I grew up around. And even to my parents, when we talk about the phantom-based economy, I remember when the stock market crashed in 2008. I was in college at the time, and I remember going home and opening up the door to my mother's bedroom and her talking about her losing her retirement, losing her savings in that. And then I remember us also nearly losing our home. So this is serious. I'm going to try to say it again. We need a revolution. We do. And so I know there's stories like this all across the state. With Progressive Maryland, we're entering a new phase as an organization where we're looking to work more intimately within communities to connect with people, to build from the bottom up, to build a grassroots movement that can make a true change right here in Maryland. And it starts here. It starts locally. I know a lot of us, we tend to think, you know, after watching CNN and watching, you know, MSNBC or whatever you watch, hopefully not Fox News, that is this big national problem. And we think about the presidential elections. We think about, you know, what's happening in some faraway place. But right here in our backyard, in Maryland, we are in deep need of revolutionary, transformative change. So how many people in this room right now are from Maryland? How many people live in Maryland right now? Good. Then this starts today, and this starts right here. And we talk later about how you can get involved and what the next steps are. How many people have legitimately contemplated whether or not you're on the right path or whether or not your children are gonna be able to make it in this economy in the future? I tell you, my parents did too. And that's why we need a revolution. We absolutely need this. We have to start transforming our system. Progressive Maryland, we're working to truly engage in real community organizing that will lift people from the bottom up, people like you and me in this room right now, people like people all across Baltimore City and the state of Maryland, to get engaged in the process of making this systemic change happen. It's a system that's producing these problems. It's a system that's deep rooted right here in Maryland that's producing all of this. And we have to organize with a long range vision for change. I'm talking about a revolution. And I'm not telling y'all to go and pick up pitchforks or get your shotgun or anything like that. But we have to start thinking very deliberatively about how we're going to make this change. And for me, it starts locally. It starts right here. We need to make Maryland the model for what will come in the future of the United States of America and the future of the world. We can do that here. We have the power within our hands. Everybody in this room has the ability to do that. And so I want you to join me on this, join us on this journey. We have to start building. We have to start building now, and it starts today. It starts tonight.